Hello, I'm Helen Bradley. Welcome to this video tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to replace a sky using a tool called BlendIF. This helps you avoid making complex selections. There are lots of ways of replacing skies, and this is another one, and I really love it for some images that already have some sky detail. So let's see how we do this. Before we start with this effect, let's have a look and see what it is that we're trying to achieve. This is the original image I had here, and you can see that there are trees along this horizon line, which are going to make replacing the sky nearly impossible because there's no way that you want to make a selection around those trees. But this is the result that we can achieve. We've got some blue in the sky here. I can increase the opacity up, so we could get quite a blue sky, but I think probably around 50% opacity is about the best that we're going to get for this image. But I've done this in the matter of about 5 minutes, and certainly I have not made a selection of those trees. So let's see how we would get this effect. So I'm going back to my original image, and I'm going to show you the sky image I have. I tend to save skies. Whenever I see a good sky, I'll go and capture an image of it because you never know when you might need a sky. So I'm just going to put this sky image out of the way. I just want its background layer. I'm just going to drag and drop it into position on this image. If I hold shift at the same time, it gets centered. You can see it's a little bit small, but just going to drag the size of it. I'm not worried that I'm not constraining it to the correct proportions because it's clouds in the sky. Nobody's going to know what they really were supposed to look like. So I've just got rid of my sky image. So here we have in our original document, we have our snow scene on the bottom and we have our sky on the top. What we want to do is to start seeing some of the snow scene through the sky. And the way we do it is with a tool called BlendIF. I'm going to select this FX or add a layer style icon here, and I'm choosing blending options, and this is a tool that you've probably never used before. It's down the bottom here in this blending options, and what it allows us to do is to blend these two layers together. So watch what happens when I start dragging on the underlying layer slider. You can see that the trees start coming through, and so does the rest of this image. Now I want to stop at the point where I get the sky through because I actually really want my blue sky. So you can see here that this is giving me my blue sky. It's bleeding into the snow, but I'm not really worried about that at all because I've got a really strong horizon line across here that I can make a very simple selection of in a minute. The problem is, of course, that I've got a sort of all or nothing approach. This is the point where the blending is happening. If the layer below is anywhere in this sort of darkness level up to 146, I am seeing the image below. If it's lighter than 146, I'm seeing the image above. Now, this little slider can be split in two, and we're going to split it in two by holding the Alt key and dragging one side of it away. And what we do by doing that is actually spreading the area in which the two layers are blended together, so we're getting a smoother transition. And all we need to do now is to work out where it is that we're going to get the best results. So I'm looking for some blending of these trees, and this is a JPEG image, and it's a fairly low quality JPEG from a fairly old camera, so it's not going to give me the best results, but I'm still going to get an image that's going to look okay. I just need to be a little bit careful where I set these values. And I'm also going to lighten this sky a bit later on. So I think these values are pretty good, and again, all I'm interested in is what's happening around the trees, not any of this foreground detail. So I'll just click OK. Now obviously we do have a problem with the snow here because the blue sky has bled into the snow, so I'm just going to grab my literally a rectangular marquee tool and just select over the entire bottom of the image because I want all of this to be out of this filter effect. So I'm going to click here to add a layer mask to this layer, and the layer mask has gone in the wrong way around, so I'm just going to press Ctrl or Command I to flip it. You can see now that the snow has been totally removed from this effect. There is, however, some legacy problems in the mountains behind, but that is really easy to fix. I'm just clicking on the brush tool, and I'm going to choose a slightly soft edge brush. And now I'm just going to size it to make it work. So just using the square bracket key, I'm painting with black. I have my mask targeted. All I'm going to do is to just paint over these areas where the snow on the mountains behind has a blue tinge. That's all I'm interested in. And there's some more snow in there. I'm just going to make sure that we bring this out so that the trees that are in front of the mountain do not have any blue tinge in them. And this is just the world's simplest paint job. Anybody can paint that out. It's not rocket science at all. Now I'm just going to drag down the opacity of this top layer to blend it in a little bit with the layer below. And I thought probably about 60% on the original. No, it's still probably going to be about 60%. So here's our original image, and here's the new image with the sky in place. And it's been done using the BlendIF feature in Photoshop. Nice, simple tool to use when you've got an image like this, where it's fairly easy to replace the sky if you don't have to make the selection around all of those trees. I'm Helen Bradley. Thank you for joining me for this video tutorial. If you like this tutorial, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, like the video, and look out on my website at projectwoman.com for more tips, tricks, and tutorials for Photoshop, Photoshop Elements, and Lightroom.